On a Saturday night from downtown Binghamton, New York, this is Danbury Hattricks Hockey, and it starts right now on the Hattricks Digital Network. Hello, Hattricks fans, Doug Latuca with you for the second game of the weekend set between the Hattricks and the Black Bears, who are sporting some specialty jerseys tonight. They're going as the Binghamton Whalers. Hall of Fame night and an ode to the former AHL team that used to play here in Binghamton, one of the AHL squads that played in Binghamton. So tonight, the Black Bears wearing the white jerseys with the Whalers logo on the chest. Now, last night, these teams met up in the 16th meeting of the year between the sides, and it felt like a playoff game. The atmosphere here inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena, the play on the ice, defensive structure was solid for both sides, and the goaltenders were up for the task. Connor McCullum made 34 saves on 36 shots. Connor McAnanima was 30 for 31. And the Black Bears coming away with a 2-1 win, another 3 points, as they have already clinched the Empire Division title. They have 110 points coming into tonight. And they got the job done yesterday after the Hattricks started the scoring. It was Johnny Ruiz on a wrister, bar down from the high slot, got a pass from Bonin Zinchenko. That made it 1-0 at 16:30 of the first period. But then the Black Bears scored once in the second early on, right at the end of a power play. It was Cameron Clark, assisted by Connor Smith and Gavin Yates. And then in the third period, Tyson Kirkby on a rebound, slid it past the outstretched pad of Connor McCullum. The assists to Donald Oliveri and Colin Fitzgerald. So that was the game-winning goal and the decider in meeting 16 of the season between the two teams. Tonight, we've got the 17th meeting out of 18. And they are doing the Hall of Fame ceremony before the teams are announced onto the ice. So let's turn it over, take a listen.
The Hockey Hall of Fame was established in 1998 with the inaugural class of Ken Holland, Jim Matthews, and Randy McGregor. The Hall's mission is to preserve and honor the 50-year tradition of professional hockey in the greater Binghamton area. Previous inductees include Paul Crowley, Craig Duncanson, Mike Dunham, the Ferraro brothers, Denny Amell, and even the current head coach of the New York Rangers, Pete LaViolette. Last year, we welcomed former Binghamton Senator Josh Hennessy, hockey reporter Charlie Jaworski, and former BC Iceman and local coach Patrice Robitaille. Tonight, we celebrate the next chapter. Before we begin, I'd like to introduce and recognize some of our distinguished guests. Joining us on the ice, we have fellow Hall of Fame members Tom Mitchell, John Smith, and Roger Neal. And of course, the owner and president of the Binghamton Black Bears, Andreas Johansson. So, let's turn the page of this book and let's get things started. Ladies and gentlemen, the first inductee in the Binghamton Hockey Hall of Fame is a voice we all know so incredibly well. A voice that has been heard in this building for parts of four decades. A man who at birth was in fact given a real name, but is known mostly to the hockey faithful as Shimes. Shimes got his start when he stepped into the penalty box for the BC Icemen while simultaneously working the mic and music for the Junior A team up at the Polar Cap. When the AHL returned to Binghamton in 2002, Shimes kept his office, calling games for the Senators and later the Devils. When we hit the next stage of hockey in Broome County, Shimes stayed on with the Binghamton Black Bears. Currently, Shimes can be heard on Cool 106.7 in the morning. We've heard his goal calls for over 1,000 games in this building. We've heard him announce penalties and countless names on the mic. And fortunately, we eventually heard him say 50 instead of 50 when announcing the 50-50. Ladies and gentlemen, our first inductee in the 2024 Hall of Fame, Stephen Shimes Shiner.
I gotta keep this up here with me. Thank you so much. We need Ed. How you guys doing? I thought maybe, just maybe, I could get away without a script, but we all know that doesn't work out too well with me. You know, things like, can I get an amen? Purple aluminum siding. Matt Rucki, 2 minutes for checking. And a note from Grady, not one, not two, but three mispronunciations in a goal. So maybe I should stick to the script. Times New Roman, 20 point, and all in caps. Here we go. Thank you to the Binghamton Hockey Hall of Fame Committee. Once upon a time, a long time ago, BC Iceman days, make noise if you remember the Iceman. I had a call to fill in for Jacko at an Iceman game. I ended up announcing quite a few games that year, and I ended up announcing the next season as well. Patrick Snyder, BC Iceman owner at the time, took a chance and put me in the box. And now here we are. What a great and humbling honor. I want to thank the committee members, all the hockey teams, the respective owners, BC Iceman, Patrick Snyder and Bob Carr, Binghamton Senators, Tom Mitchell, Tom Bowles, and Tim Smith. New Jersey Devils, with a franchise run by Tom Mitchell. And the Black Bears, Andreas Johansson. You can't do my job. Oh my gosh, thank you so much for that. That's awesome. You can't do a job like mine without operations managers John McGraw, Chris Blanchette, Krista Reese, Matt the General Custer, Savannah Altieri, Mike Karpovich, Connor Gates, and Trevor Potentino. The arena managers in my time, Mike Marinaccio, Brian Hoffman, Anthony Caposi, and Chris Marion. All of the arena staff members I've met over the years, from all the Redcoats who were always so kind to me, the Zam drivers and all the concession staff, the music directors, Jim Free, my buddy Mo Taylor. Yeah, make some noise for Mo. And Pete, I never knew your name, dude. I just know you as Pete. So thank you. Everybody make noise for Pete up in the booth. Our promo teams, TJ and Lisa, Ben Spurduni, and many, many more. All the mascots, Justin McGregor, Mike Kelly, Tim Miller, my son Michael, Jevin, and many others. The video directors and their crews, Keith Engelke and Josh Williams, and their staff, Gary, Adam, Jeff, Frankie, Kurt, and all the camera operators. Thank you to the radio broadcasters who helped me along the way. Mike Thornton, Rob Lapolis, Brooks Hill, but most of all, thank you to Grady Wittenberg, Binghamton Hockey Hall of Famer. Oh, and on that note, by the way, I'd like to thank Nikita Kucherov, Vladislav Namestnikov, and Dmitry Korobov for the hardest goal call ever. And I also want to thank the most fun name to say, and pardon it, cover the kids' ears, Corey Pecker. I want to thank the office upstairs workers and all of the interns and photographers. Just Sports Photography, Bill and Nancy, Tom Ryder. All of the off-ice officials over the years, not only in the penalty box area like Deke, and all those guys, but mostly my buddy, my pal, my friend, my father, basically, Don Phillips. Yeah. Don was a special man, I'll tell you, he was a gentleman's gentleman. And I also want to take a moment to thank all the players whose names I got to call that are playing in the NHL or just even live here in Binghamton and didn't get to go on. I want to thank Section 17 right there in the middle, my Equinox Broadcasting family. They support my efforts over the years, Ray, John, Thunder, Tom, Mina, Judith, Barb, Jen, Mo, Sue, Mike, Kevin, and Liam, and our owners, George Harris, Barb Harris, and Kevin Fitzgerald. My children, they couldn't be here today because they're at Office Air Force Base at Omaha, Nebraska. Technical Sergeant Ashley Trim and Michael Scheimer, who is also a sergeant in the Air Force. And a very sincere thank you for all the support from Natalie from Sirius XM Radio. Thank you. But most of all, really, I want to thank all of you. From the super fans back at the day, Super Dave, YMCA Dave, the Chicken Man, Eddie the Twister, PFPP, Dave the Yogler, and the Booster Club, including Teresa G, Lori Ann, Lorraine, Sally, and Dick, and all the Booster Club members. Thank you to the season ticket holders and every single fan. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you. Just a couple of minutes, I want to go over a couple of things that happened. I was fortunate enough to make a wish to a little girl who met Hannah Montana right out there in Center Ice. I got to announce the AHL MVP, Jason Spezza. Two All-Star games, a UHL All-Star game and an AHL All-Star game. And I got the privilege to announce the DML and local hockey star at the time, and he's still playing hockey, Jerry DiVigo. And last but not least, the 2007 Calder Cup season. From the day in March after the Moose Club Player Awards, I said to coach, you got a team. You're gonna go all the way. And we did, didn't we? We 2011 Calder Cup champions! So a couple personal notes. Portland game, it's rocking in here. Everybody's rocking, the place is packed. Music is jamming with Mo. Mo had it thumping. And then the PA system died. And I walked out on the ice. I said, I got this. And everybody's like, no, I got this. I walk out and I introduce Connor Gates for the national anthem. And not only did he sing it, he belted it out of the arena, out of the park, past Covey Cove. You nailed that. Thank you to everybody for that special memory when you all joined in and sang the national anthem as well. My favorite memory though, the party outside the arena, after the parade. Who remembers that? Yeah. The most perfect music ever for an awards thing, and it was all Mo. That was all you. We had a lot of fun then. That day was very fun, didn't we, Coach? So, thanks for the memories. Thank you for letting me try my very best to inform you and maybe just a little entertain you as well. There it is. My script's come to an end. And so has my time here at the arena. Frank, it's your turn. Thank you for the wonderful honor. Black Bear fans, are you ready for some hockey?
Our second and
Binghamton hockey history. Ladies and gentlemen, Coach Kirk Kleinenhorst. Coach Kleinenhorst joined the Binghamton Senators before the start of the 2010 season. That year, he led the Sens to a 42-33-5 record for 92 points and the city's first postseason appearance in 5 years. Binghamton clinched the final spot in the playoffs that year. But once June hit, there was only one team in the AHL that got to hoist the Calder Cup. Taking 4 out of 6 games from the Houston Aeros, Coach brought the city of Binghamton their first and only Calder Cup in this city's history. He led the Sens for 2 more seasons, including a return in 2016. Aside from Binghamton, he has led the Raleigh Icecaps, San Diego Gulls, the Lowell Devils, and has been on the bench with the New Jersey Devils, among many others. Currently, he splits time between Minnesota and Utah with Dion, his wife. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome back to Binghamton the Calder Cup winning coach, Kirk Kleinenhorst.
Thank you so much, Connor. I think before I get started, I gotta be honest with you, I'm standing over there and I'm listening to Steve and I'm like, holy crap, how do I follow that guy? Like, that was amazing, and that's something that for 26 years, people that have sat up here have had a chance to experience, and I think it's absolutely phenomenal. And then the other thing is, the one thing, and we'll get more to the fans, we'll get a little bit more to the community, I promise you this will not be long, but I appreciate you all for how honest you are as people, and I'll give you an example. So I'm walking here from my hotel, on my way to the game, and there's somebody up there right now that knows exactly what I'm gonna say. And he says, holy smokes, he says, you sure get dressed up for a game. And I'm like, yeah, I do actually, because this is really what I love, right? So as I'm walking in, one of the fans is like, wow, you really do get dressed up. But I gotta be, what a great moment. And for those of you that have followed the B-Sens, I think you'll know exactly where I'm coming from. I think you'll know exactly. This is such a special moment for me. I can't even begin to tell you. An honor, a privilege, and a major league thank you. And when Connor called me, I hung up the phone, I shared the news with my wife, and I started to reflect. And you know, the one thing that I realized quickly is like, this is definitely not a me moment. This is a we moment. Like, this is all about everybody that has been a part. And I know that this is a lot about the championship, right? Like, I get that, but that's my point exactly. This is about the we, and we're all part of the we. And my wife is probably the biggest we in the Hawks, because you don't do what I do for 30 some years, drag your family all over the country, all over the world, and not have a rock behind you. And my wife was absolutely my rock, and for 38 years I've been married to the best and most wonderful woman there is in the world. Steve, 26 years, that's amazing, that's part of the we. Connor, you're part of the we. Tom Mitchell's part of the we. Steve Sterling, my right-hand man while I was here, he's part of the we. Matty Meacham, Rick Walmsley, Glenn Kinney, Tommy Severin, Seve. We all know who these people are, and they're all part of the we. And we don't do what we did if we don't have everybody behind us. I remember like yesterday, pulling in next door to the Holiday Inn. I had my little trailer behind me. We had a few belongings. My wife, Dion, that I talked about earlier, had this little tomato plant that I had to go out and water every day in the parking lot. It was just a surreal moment that I remember like it was yesterday. And to be able to come into this building and to experience the fans the way that we experienced it was amazing. And like Steve mentioned, we managed to qualify for the Calder Cup. And again, for those of you that were following us, you're going to know exactly where it all started. And it was in Manchester. We're losing the series 3-1. And somehow, some way, our group found a way to win every single game, all 4 games, in overtime. We had to get a save out of Robin Leonard in overtime. We had to tie game 7-up with our goalie out, and we somehow find a way to go on and win a cup. That, to me, is really what this is all about. I want to talk a little bit about the fans, because again, when I talk about the we, I really do want you to understand, and I know even with the Black Bears, like the fans can have such an impact on how games turn out. And what I remember is how loyal, how faithful, and how positive the fans were. And it absolutely makes a difference. Okay? And lastly for me, it's about the community. It's about Binghamton. I absolutely fell in love with Binghamton, and to this day, the one thing that I will tell anybody that will listen is, like, in my mind, Binghamton is underrated, and it is absolutely a hidden gem. And I think that that's something to be said for everybody sitting here. You're underappreciated, but not by me. So, just one last big thank you, because after tonight, I'll be back, but I don't know that there's going to be a stage bigger than this or an honor bigger than this that I can be part of, but I can tell you that I'll be back, and I'll be driving the streets of Binghamton, and I'll appreciate each and every one of you, and I'll appreciate the community like I always have. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. We'll always share our Calder Cup together.
Presenting Kurt with his plaque, please welcome Binghamton Senators Executive Vice President and Hall of Fame member, Tom Mitchell. Once again, on behalf of the Binghamton Black Bears, the Binghamton Hockey Hall of Fame Committee, and all of the great hockey fans that have been coming to this building for over 50 years, let's give our inductees a great big hand. Have a great night, enjoy the game, and let's continue to support your hometown team as they look to bring another championship to the city of Binghamton. Let's go! Wait a minute. Let's go, Whalers!
Hello again, Hattricks fans. Doug Latuca with you. The Black Bears wrapping up a pregame ceremony. They inducted two members into the Binghamton Hockey Hall of Fame. Former Binghamton Senators head coach Kirk Kleinendorst, and then a former public address announcer Stephen Scheimer. Now, the Binghamton Senators won the Calder Cup back in 2011 in the AHL. And 2011, they won the Calder Cup trophy in the AHL. So a nice ceremony off the top. And that's just part one of what should be an eventful night here in Binghamton. The Black Bears turning into the Whalers tonight, sporting the Binghamton Whalers colors, the green and the blue. The Whalers around for a long time. in Binghamton from 1980 to 1990. They are being honored tonight, bringing it back, as the Black Bears have done all season with a couple of different odes to some former teams, including the Binghamton Rangers. We saw them wearing the jerseys earlier this season. And now they will announce the starting lineup for the Binghamton Black Bears. We're going to call them the Black Bears tonight, even though they are going as the Whalers, to avoid any confusion. Keep it pretty simple. The lights have flicked on. Starting lineups being announced for both of these teams. Then the anthem, and then hockey time here in Binghamton. The teams did face off last night. Black Bears won it 2-1. The defensive battle, both goalies stood on their head. But the Black Bears getting the game-winning goal about midway through that second period, a third period rather, to win the game 2-1. Patrick's with just two wins in the last six matchups against Binghamton. But teams hadn't seen each other here in Binghamton since January 20th, before last night. And we were talking to some of the fans, even some of the coaches mentioned the playoff feeling last night in that game. This could be a preview of round two in the playoffs. That's if both of these teams win in their first round matchup. And we'll have plenty more on the scenarios as the game goes on. It's time for the anthem here in Binghamton.
And now, performing our national anthem, please welcome from Tri-Cities Opera House, Janine Dworin and Kyrie Laburn.
It is time for hockey in downtown Binghamton, New York. The Danbury Hattricks and the Binghamton Black Bears for the 17th time out of 18 this season. The Hattricks in third place in the Empire Division, 5 points behind the Motor City Rockers for the second spot. They are 29-18-5 with 83 points. The Black Bears are 35-10-7. With 110 points, they have locked up the Empire Division. They will either play Elmira or Watertown in round one, where the Hattricks will face off with the Rockers We're just not sure where game one of that series will be. Black Bears have won two in a row, but have dropped four of their last six games, struggling defensively. In all four of those losses, they've surrendered four-plus goals. As for the Hattricks, they have wins in six of the last seven. Their win streak was snapped last night in a 2-1 defeat here in Binghamton. Hattricks have also won 13 of the past 17 games, grabbing 34 of a possible 51 points. Black Bears start with the third line of Cam Clark, who scored last night. Josh Fletcher and Justin Somero did not play. He's back in for Binghamton. Dan Weaver and JT Walters are on defense. Walters coming back from a one-game suspension for abuse of an official, and Nolan Egbert is the starting netminder. The puck is dropped, and we are underway. Hattricks are in the orange jerseys, black pants, and orange socks with the striping. Black Bears are in the Binghamton Whalers jerseys with the Whaler logo, black pants, and the white socks with the striping. Hattricks starting with their third line. Chase Harwell centering Nick DiNicola and Corey Cunningham. Josh LaBelle and Charlie Bedard are the defensive pair. And it's Taylor Joseph making his return to Binghamton. Came to town last year, started all five playoff games for Binghamton, including three against the Hattricks, where he posted a 1.83 goals against average and a .937 save percentage during that postseason. And tonight making his fourth start with the Hattricks as a .233 goals against and a .935 save percentage. The 6-1 netminder was a defensive battle last night. Johnny Ruiz scored the only goal in the first period, and that was the only goal for the Hattricks all night. Black Bears ice the puck, and the Hattricks make changes. Billy Berry, Jacob Ratcliffe, Connor Woolley, three up front with the steady D pair of Xavier Abdella and Kyle Gonzalez.
For a cooler, check out their table tonight as well.
Face off at the near circle. Berry wins it. Gonzalez shoots. Saved by Egbert on the top of his crease. It was Connor McAnanima in net for Binghamton last night. Tonight, it is Nolan Egbert from Long Island. Comes in with a 10-5-2 record. Goals against average around .340 and the save percentage at .883. Puck squirts to Dakota Bond, streaks up the near side, pressed on. A dangle try through the legs by Thompson. It spits to the far corner, Abdella tied up with Bond. Here's Thompson shooting, left pad save. Kirkby corrals below the goal line. He lost the handle. Abdella angles for Woolley, chips it up the boards. Bond smeared along the glass by Ratcliffe. It's back in the zone. Here's Oliveri on the backhand. Scores! Through the five hole of Joseph. And a minute and 57 seconds in, the Black Bears strike first. Well, the fans love it, and that is not the start the Hattricks and head coach Billy McCreary were hoping for after a hard-fought back-and-forth affair last night.
Binghamton Whalers goal!
Maybe we'll see a little bit more offense here tonight. So Binghamton off to a good start. Don Oliveri with his 16th goal of the season. Bond gets an assist on the goal. Gavin Yates closed off, swoops around the net. LaBelle swipes it off of his blade, kept in at the blue line by Steffen. Here's Steffen, shoots, scores! Bar down, 2-0 Black Bears. 231 in, and it's all Binghamton so far. My goodness. So the hat tricks with a lot of work to do. We haven't even played 3 minutes, and the hat tricks in a two-goal hole. McKittrick up top, slap shot, stopped by Egbert. Rebound in front, it's underneath Ruiz. He's on his knees, and then it's pried free by Jesse Anderson. A scrum in front of Egbert, who stands tall, keeps the puck out of the net. Tyson Kirkby paces the Black Bears in all three offensive categories, scored last night. Pass inside for Anderson. Anderson, cross corner dump, Oliveri, slap shot, save. Rebound stuffed at the left pad, and Joseph keeps it out. Now Colby Johnson, number 81, gets a change, but he was out on the ice. Top line winger with Ruiz and McKittrick was in the spotlight a bit yesterday. Mixing some things up. Wasn't an overly physical or a nasty game yesterday. A couple of post-whistle scrums, but nothing like we saw last night in Watertown between the River Sharks and Wolves. Led to 8 indefinite suspensions. Walters' snapshot stopped by Joseph. Swept back in by Weber. Abdella attempted a hit on Fletcher, he sidestepped it. Weber couldn't hold the line and sprints after it. 4 minutes in, first period, and the Black Bears hold a 2-0 lead. Harwell forces the turnover, leads DiNicola left wing, centering pass blocked. Back to DiNicola, sends it to the back. LaBelle, wrist shot, deflected wide. Weber pounces on it. Cross ice feed, nullified. LaBelle gathers in, steps over the red line, and floats it to the right of Egbert. He'll steer it to Stone, a giveaway. DiNicola shoots, save Egbert. Kicked out the left pad. And it's Yates at center. 7 shots for Binghamton. We haven't even played 5 minutes yet. First goal, Oliveri through the 5-hole of Joseph. The second one, Steffen at 2:31. Fired it underneath the bar. Stone chips it in. Steffen the goal scorer. Pressed on by Pamelayan. There's Riley Robertson making his season debut with the hat tricks. Was a member of the Danbury Championship winning team last year. The 6'6 D-man. Yates spinning, centers, Bond in front, kick save, rebound! Was stopped by Joseph as well. Bond all alone on the doorstep, and Joseph, with his best save, keeps it 2-0 Binghamton. Egbert out of the net. Hands off for Kirkby. Johnson flies by him. And Kirkby receives a pass left wing. Into the zone, Kirkby feathers it below the goal line. Thompson shoved by Abdella. Free puck, Barry has it. Playing it his 10th game with the hat tricks. College rookie, 4 goals in his last 3 games and points in 7 of the last 8 games. Fitzgerald throws it to the middle and the play is offsides. Early stages, period number 1, and it's been all Black Bears. They lead 2-0. We'll step aside here on the Hat Tricks Digital Network.
Stop by TK's American Cafe on White Street in Danbury and try one of their 76 amazing wing flavors. Visit tksamericancafe.com for more information.
Danbury Parking Authority. Park in the Patriot Garage across the street from the Danbury Ice Arena. It's safe, secure, and legal. Make sure the only ticket you get is to the game.
Danbury Chiropractic and Wellness. Dr. Jared DiLorenzo is a proud member of the Danbury Hat Tricks medical team. Stop by and see them on North Street in downtown Danbury. Feeling good is an option, and they can get you there.
BuzzAid Appliance Scratch and Dent Outlet is the local leader for appliances and household wares. Do you like to eat? They have a refrigerator. Do you want clean clothes? They have a washer. They got it all. It's BuzzAid Appliance. Coca-Cola is the official beverage of the Danbury Hat Tricks. Sweet, fizzy goodness. As refreshing as you remember.
Back inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena in Binghamton, New York. Black Bears 2, Hat Tricks nothing. We've played 6 minutes and 23 seconds. Goals from Don Oliveri and Kyle Steffen at 157 and 231. Have the Black Bears off and running. Now the Hat Tricks in a 2-goal hole. Shots are 9-3, Binghamton. Outlet pass ramped out of play. Binghamton in their Binghamton Whalers jerseys. White unis with the green and blue accents with the B Whalers logo on the chest. Hat Tricks once again in the orange as they were last night. LaBelle on the back end with Bedard, flicks it on goal. Egbert steered it to safety. LaBelle keeps in. Cunningham at the left circle, shoots, deflected. Behind the net, they battle for it. Bedard pinched in from the right point, spinning off of a check. Bedard centers, blocked by Kirkby. Bedard pressing Kirkby to the glass. A scrum in the corner, Bedard shoving with Thompson. We play on, and Kirkby sauces it to Fitzgerald. Streaking through, gave it away. DiNicola turning in the corner, keeps it alive in the offensive zone. Puck was in the skates of Thompson behind the play. Jesse Anderson and DiNicola going at it. Now Kirkby and DiNicola at center. DiNicola shoving Kirkby. Now Oliveri comes over. There's Harwell talking to him as well. The puck is behind the Binghamton net. Refs are in between Harwell and Oliveri. Johnson is there. Oh, that's the guy the Hat Tricks want. We'll see if Oliveri wants to go. He does not. He goes to the bench instead. Temper starting to flare. Joseph flips it to the near side. Gave it away to Somero. Low to high, Weber. Straight away, Walters, slap shot. Waffle saved by Joseph, pops in the air to the near corner. Available at the blue line, Pamelain leading for Johnson, given away. Weber drops off for Logar, back for Weber, too hot to handle, all the way through, and Dustin Henning back on defense for the Hat Tricks, paired with Pamelain tonight. 39-year-old defenseman. Hat Tricks without Jared Yao, Michael Falanga, and Bodin Zinchenko tonight. Gonzalez chases after the puck. A whistle and a penalty.
Hey fans, don't forget to stop on the concourse and grab.
Charging the call on Colby Joseph. Rather, Colby Johnson. We mentioned he was in the spotlight yesterday. And he is not happy about the charging call. Smashed his stick against the glass and fired his glove on the floor. It's 2-0 Binghamton. They've controlled this one from the jump. Goals at 157 and 231 of the period. And now the top power play in the FPHL can get to work. Hat Tricks last night were 6-for-6 on the kill against Binghamton's power play. 28% of the time they convert. That's the best in the league. Hat Tricks have the 4th-ranked penalty kill. Just under 82%. Oliveri inside for Logar. His shot was blocked. Bond gives off. Kirkby shoots. Airmailed it. It wheels around for Oliveri. Bouncing puck kept in by Bond at the line. Return Oliveri. Slap shot blocked by Robertson, who was standing tall. Hit him right in the leg. Hat-trick's clear. And get a change. 1:10 to work with for the Black Bears on the power play. Kirkby gets it back from Thompson. Center point Stone. Back for Kirkby. Near side Oliveri shoots. Blocked by Berry. Swing and a miss on the rebound. Black Bears keep it alive. Stone to Oliveri. Midway point of the first period. 40 seconds on the man advantage. Oliveri, wrist shot, ramped off the stick of Joseph and out of play. And we've hit the media timeout. 37 seconds remaining on the Johnson penalty.
Let's ask these Bears how our ice is looking tonight.
We'll step aside. You're watching Danbury Hat-Tricks Hockey on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network.
Coltech, the founder of Plastic Chamber Technology, is headquartered locally in Brookfield. Coltech is family-owned and operated with experience in the drainage industry dating back to the 1950s. When you're talking drainage and stormwater, Coltech is the world leader. Contact them today at coltech.com.
Fairfield County Bank is the official bank of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. It's where the Hat-Tricks bank and the tellers wear the Danbury Hat-Tricks top hat. Fairfield County Bank is your hometown bank and a proud supporter of your hometown team.
For a comfortable stay with great amenities, the only choice is the La Quinta by Wyndham in Danbury. Ask for the Hat-Tricks friends and family rate. You can't beat it. La Quinta.
Texas Roadhouse, located on Newtown Road in Danbury, opened its doors locally in 2017 and is known for hand-cut steaks, cactus blossom, fall-off-the-bone ribs, made-from-scratch sides, and fresh-baked bread. The restaurant prides itself on its legendary food, legendary service, and legendary fun.
Back in Binghamton, Black Bears 2, Hat-Tricks nothing. We're just over the midway point of the opening period. Shots are 13-4 Black Bears, and they have 37 seconds remaining on a power play. Johnson is in the box for charging. Off the faceoff. Hat-Tricks control. Puck is sailed all the way down for Ruiz. Leads the Hat-Tricks in shorthanded goals with four. Almost had another one there, but Egbert closed the wickets. Black Bears gain the zone. Here's Clark through the legs. Stopped by Joseph. Almost a highlight reel power play goal from Clark, who scored last night on a dirty goal in front, a putback. Tonight showing off the hands and almost extended the lead to three. Well, the Hat-Tricks were 6-for-6 on the kill yesterday. They are 1-for-1 thus far, and a crucial one. Did not want to go down 3-0 to the Empire-leading Black Bears. It's the second game of the weekend between the two teams and 17th meeting out of 18 this season. Stefan quickly to Stone. He'll wheel it around. Stefan crunched by Berry. Angled off the boards and wobbles out to center ice. Fitzgerald, D to D. Anderson up for Clark. Pocket picked by Berry. Bouncing puck. Fitzgerald scoops it with the glove forward. And Clark leads Yates into the offensive zone. Worked down by Gonzalez. Yates around the net. Gonzalez still on him. Hounding him from behind. Yates cross slot feed. Received by Anderson. Wrist shot blocked by Woolley. Liam Anderson not in the lineup for Binghamton. It is number 77, Jesse Anderson, who's playing on defense today. Puck is shoveled out to center and flipped in by Berry. Hat-Tricks make a change with 8 minutes to go. First period, 2-0 Binghamton. Black Bears won 6 of the first 7 meetings between these two teams. Then the Hat-Tricks went on a 3-game winning streak right as the calendar was set to flip to 2024. pops into the Binghamton bench.
Do you have tech that got wrecked?
But in the last six meetings, the Hattricks have won just twice. Their only regulation win versus Binghamton was January 19th, 4-3 come-from-behind win. And prior to last night, the Hattricks had not set foot in Binghamton since the 20th of January. Teams will face off one more time after tonight. It's the Hattricks' season finale at home next Friday. McKittrick harassed by Weber. Buck in the skates, Pamelaeans, slapper, whizzes wide. Kept in by Henning at the right point. Feathers it below the goal line. Johnson for McKittrick behind him. And Thompson off to the races up the left wing. Gibson chases, Joseph is out of the net. Whacks it near side, Kirkby shoots, kick save. Thompson for Oliveri behind the goal, tried a bank shot. Henning walled him off. And Ruiz flips it up the board, centering try for Johnson, put right back on the stick of Weber. Weber was stopped momentarily. Kirkby picks up the change. Kirkby strong on the wall, forces it middle, all the way through. Oliveri shoot save, rebound whacked at. A Black Bear is down in the crease. Nothing called. Johnson up the left wing. Into the offensive zone, Johnson, left the puck, Cunningham, turning, looking, hands off LaBelle, one hand to the goal, stopped by Egbert with a glove save, and no rebound. Egbert has not been tested too much in this game, just the fifth shot from the Hattricks. The Black Bears have peppered Joseph with 17 shots, and despite the rough start for Taylor, he has been sharp in the latter stages of this period. Five-hole goal given up to Oliveri, and then the Stefan snipe off the crossbar and down. Yates navigates into the zone, stopped by Bedard. And Woolley finds Bedard in the near corner. Sauced ahead past Ratcliffe. And Stone charges up the right side. Black Bears gain the line. Ratcliffe along the board, centered, gave it away. Turnaround slapper wide. Stone at the right point. Fanned on the shot, flips it down low, centering pass. LaBelle intercepts. But Hattricks give up possession at center. Tosto was denied, and it's Johnny Ruiz. Had the only goal yesterday for the Hattricks. Ruiz shoots. The toe says no. Egbert stuck it out. Abdella at the left point for Ruiz. Inside McKittrick fighting for it. He was taken down, and Egbert puts his glove on top to get a whistle. Right in front of the crease, that is Cunningham, who was chucked to the ice. Ruiz with a nice move to gain the zone. Kick save from Egbert, and DiNicola could not get his stick free. Face off at the near circle, Fletcher and Ruiz. Hattricks win it. Gonzalez at the right point. Wrist shot stop. Rebound poked through. Egbert's got it underneath. It's still free, and Clark takes it away. Two on two the other way. Clark cuts middle. Samaro joins. Shoots wide. All the way around it goes. Cunningham touches for Ruiz. Under five to go, first period. Ruiz floats it in. Out of the reach of Cunningham, and Jesse Anderson leads the breakout the other way. Samaro crunched in front of the Hattricks bench by Harwell. Exactly what the Hattricks were looking for. Both teams have been extremely physical in the first 15 minutes. And Joseph makes the save and thought about a stretch pass, but goes backwards with it to Pamelaeans.
DiNicola across for Robertson, dangles through. Patrick's keep it moving forward. Kirkby intercepts, lost the handle to Harwell, and a whistle. Believe the play was offsides. Final timeout of period number one. Black Bears still holding on to a 2-0 lead. Right here on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Diversified Printing Solutions in Danbury is the Hattricks official printing partner. You want it printed? Call Tina and let them get it inked up for you. They could do it all. Locally owned and printed on paper from Connecticut trees.
Dr. Matt Hartsburg is an official member of the Danbury Hattricks medical team. Hartsburg Chiropractic is cutting-edge chiropractic care right here in your backyard. Check out Hartsburg Chiropractic and get on the road to a pain-free hockey season. Blue Light Electric is a proud sponsor of the Danbury Hattricks. Blue Light Electric happily provides service to all parts of Connecticut, performing high-quality electrical work for residential and commercial properties. Blue Light Electric is always accepting new customers.
Litchfield Distillery. It's the spirit of hard work. The Batchers of Litchfield Distillery, in honor of the early farmers of Northwest Connecticut, present to you the locally made Litchfield Distillery bourbon, vodka, and gin. Grab a beverage at the Rabbit Hole and hoist the barrel with the Hattricks.
Back inside Vision's Veterans Memorial Arena in downtown Binghamton, New York. Doug Latuca with you on the Hattricks Digital Network. 4:04 left, first period. Binghamton 2, Danbury nothing. On two goals scored 34 seconds apart from each other. The first one, Oliveri from Bond at 1:57. And then Steffen unassisted at 2:31. Hattricks have picked up their play as of late. This game very physical thus far. And Egbert has made some stellar stops, as has Joseph after surrendering the first two goals. He's made 15 saves on 17 shots. Puck is lofted through center. And behind the play, puck was touched with a high stick, I believe. So the face-off to the left of Joseph in the Hattricks zone. Now, Johnson thought he was called for another penalty. But the Hattricks survive. Keep it 5-on-5. Kirkby and Berry for the face-off. Finds Oliveri, but he lost it to Woolley. Walters knocked him off the puck. LaBelle bout backtracking. Ahead for Berry, who tips it in. Weber retrieves. Ratcliffe all over him. Weber emerges, splits through Berry and Woolley. Kirkby into the zone. Drops off Oliveri. Back for Kirkby. Stone joins the play late. Bouncing puck. Could not settle. And Ratcliffe, handcuffed by Weber, lost possession. And Oliveri camped out behind the net with 3 minutes remaining in the opening period. 2-0 Binghamton. Hattricks in action again tomorrow, 3 o'clock puck drop in Danbury. Skate with the team post game. Final Sunday regular season game of the year. And that is the second to last game of the regular season. Today, the final road game, actually, for Danbury in the regular campaign. And not sure if game one of the playoffs will be in Motor City or in Danbury. Steffen, who has a goal today, gave it to Yates. Shoots, stop, rebound to Steffen. The shot off the chest of Joseph, and it goes in. On the third or fourth effort, Joseph was down and out, and the Black Bears make it 3-0. Blake Tosto with the goal, his sixth of the season. Pinballing around, Joseph made two or three stops, and the rebound flipped over his head. The Hattricks find themselves in a bit of trouble in the late stages of this first period. Hostile environment here in Binghamton, and the fans with something to cheer about. Not much Joseph could do on that one, as he had already made a couple of saves prior to the goal. Here's Steffen up the right wing, floats one on, and a stick save by Joseph into the netting. So Steffen and Bond get the assist. So Steffen with 2 points tonight. Same thing for Bond. Steffen with a goal and an assist. Bond with two helpers. Face off to the left of Joseph. One forward by Binghamton, put on and kicked out by Joseph. The rebound off the side of the net. Steffen was standing at the right circle and the puck found his stick. Almost a 3-point first period for Steffen. Yates in the slot, wrist shot blocked. Johnson. Lead pass for DiNicola behind him. Hattrick's making changes. Binghamton right back in. Steffen walled off by Harwell. It's in front. Here's Yates. Drops off. Shuts. Was deflected in front. Fitzgerald from the point creeped in. Yates almost gave up possession. Has it back at the center ice logo. Woolley on his hip. Samaro tried to slide for Yates. Picked off by Harwell. Hard pass. Ratcliffe up the right wing. Shoots. Saved by Egbert. He swats it with the stick to the near corner. Clark shoves Ratcliffe down. He lost his helmet. Skates back to the bench. Under a minute to go. First period. 3-0 Binghamton. Anderson navigates through center. Steps over the red line. Flips it in. Joseph rims it around. Woolley. Right up the gut, Cunningham. It sprung right off his skate, and Binghamton possesses in the offensive zone. Joseph out of the net, gave it away. Centering pass picked off by McKittrick with 20 seconds. 3-on-2 for the Hattricks. McKittrick for Cunningham. Cunningham shoots, glove save, Egbert. Rebound to the right point. Binghamton could counter with 10. Logar, left wing. Logar shoots, save, rebound, swiped by Ruiz, and that is it. Somewhat of a disastrous first period for the Hattricks. They give up 23 shots. Joseph made 20 saves in period number one, allowed 3 goals. And after 20, the Black Bears hold a 2-0 lead, a 3-0 lead. 2 minutes and 31 seconds into the period, it was 2-0 Binghamton. And Tosto adding the third at 17:48 to push the advantage. So a dream start for the Binghamton Black Bears on Hall of Fame night, wearing the Whalers jerseys. And for the Hattricks, the good news is they have 40 minutes to turn this around and crawl back into this game. Mention the Hattricks have struggled as of late against Binghamton, very reminiscent of the early season meetings between the sides. Hattricks with just 2 wins in the last 6 games, and one of them coming in overtime back on March 9th. We mentioned last night the Hattricks struggled offensively, just 1 goal by Ruiz in period number one. So it has been now 3 full periods since the Hattricks have scored a goal. So back to the drawing board as Billy McCreary and company try to find a bit of a spark for the remainder of this game.
So here we go. The idea is, these guys,
and the Hattricks have to travel home tonight and play on Sunday. So tomorrow at 3 o'clock in Danbury against Elmira, a team that needs points as badly as any team in the league right now, as they are in a dogfight with Watertown for the fourth and final playoff spot. All right, about 16 and a half minutes until the second period gets underway here in Binghamton. So the Hatricks struggling in the first 20 minutes. They do have time to turn it around, and they very well can if they would like to. So after one period of play, it is the Black Bears 3 and the Hatricks nothing. We will step aside here on the Hatricks Digital Network. We caught up with a couple of the Danbury players, Colby Johnson, Xavier Abdella, and Jacob Ratcliffe earlier on this week. We did play the interviews last night, but for those who did not see it, let's take a look at how that went. After, we talk about our friends at Yard Goats Landscaping. Do you like your grass green or do you want weeds? Yard Goats Landscaping and Construction services Fairfield and Litchfield County. Their specialties are tree service, excavation, patios, decks, and making your grass happy. Check out yardgoats.io and get green with the team.
Colby Johnson, how are you doing today?
Oh, I'm doing great. How are you doing?
Good. So you've been here a week and a half.
Yeah.
On behalf of every fan, welcome to the team. Welcome to Danbury.
Hey, thank you. I'm happy to be here.
So this past weekend, you scored your first goal.
Yep.
Right into it. How did it feel?
Oh, it was awesome. It was really easy. Johnny made a sick play. Tricky lifted his leg up too. Knew that play was coming. Just had to go down with my stick down on the ice and just tapping. You know?
You've been here for two games, one home, one away. In the span, you racked up one goal, three assists. What have you brought so far to the team, and what do you continue and hope to bring to the team?
Just energy, spark, presence on the ice. You know, like that. If you mess around, you might have to find out. You know, I haven't had to fight anybody yet, but that's something that'll come. At some point.
Definitely been able to learn that big fighter. Do you think that contributes to the way that you play, especially like size and because you're a winger and, you know, it all contributes, but how would you say that it does?
I grew up watching Jerome McGinley, Wayne Simmons, Donald Brashear, because they're like colored players in the Canadian market, right? And the one thing they all had in common was that they fought. Donald Brashear didn't score as many goals. Maybe George Larocq scored more goals. Anson Carter, guys like that. I knew that fighting, you know, it's something that sparks people because, like, you're ready to go to war for your guys. You know, whether it's, like, a spark in you're up or you're down. Like, if you're trying to put the nail in the coffin or you're trying to, you know, bring the team back to life or just set a tone early, stick up for a teammate, you know, there's that kind of stuff. And I think that is just an intangible that, I bring to my game to kind of give me some more space. I was kind of in a box doing that for a little while when I was 16, 17, 18. I built a history, you know, and now people don't really test me as much, but, you know, just knowing that it's there, you know, like maybe people won't be screwing around quite as much, you know.
Yeah, so definitely bringing those attributes and those skill set. Growing up, you played in the juniors, you played in the WHL, you played in multiple leagues, came from the SPHL here. How has that transition been like to play almost all over, different leagues, different teams?
After a while, you know, the game stays the same. That's a big saying among the boys in every league. It's just, you know, X's and O's are similar. It's just, you know, sometimes the efficiency to get plays done more often, or, you know, if you make a mistake, like, people will, like, in some leagues, like, people will make you pay right away, but it's usually just team by team, right? Every league has its teams that, you know, are just going to make you pay every single time you make a mistake. With this league, I find there's more fans, like into it. You know, U Sports, you can't really fight. So then, like, it's more student section stuff, and they're just there to get rowdy, you know, and pre-drink a little bit. Here, it's people are, you know, here to be entertained, right? You know, in all kinds of ways. So you never really know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
Puck drops. Yeah.
So winding it all the way back, growing up, small town in Saskatchewan, Canada.
Yeah.
How'd you even get into hockey when you were younger?
Well, my mom played. My dad, he's from Jamaica, so he didn't really play, but he was a fan of the game, fan of Patrick Waugh. Like, I was living in Pinoca, Alberta, until I was 9. And that's in between Edmonton and Calgary. Calgary's captain, one of the best hockey players of all time, Jerome McGinley. And then Edmonton had guys like Anson Carter, George Laroque, like all kinds of, like Greer, all kinds of guys who, you know, looked like me. And my dad would be like, hey, like, watch that guy. You could be like that someday, right? And then we would go to WHL games, and the team in Red Deer, right beside Pinoca, they won the Memorial Cup when I was there, and there was a guy named Colby Armstrong on the team, and my dad was like, hey, he's the same name as you, and he could do that. So there's ice all the time in these areas too, like in northern Saskatchewan, where I moved to after. Like, it's cold most of the year, so there's nothing to do other than just go to the outdoor rink and just play the game, you know, just all day.
A lot of outdoors, yeah. A lot of hockey. You've mentioned Jerome McGinley a lot. Would you consider that to be your favorite player? Or if not, you know, what is your favorite player? Do you have a favorite hockey team?
Jerome McGinley is my favorite player of all time. Yeah, for sure. Just what he did, playing with the Flames, and just watching him and hoping that he'd get his cup that he never did. But he's a Christian leader, and I think it's like pretty symbolic that he never got his cup, because he brought so much more to the game than just, you know, that accolade. He brought great leadership and a lot of passion, and he was a great role model, right? And he's a great shepherd, just for the game and for Christ as well. So he's probably my favorite player of all time. But my favorite player right now is probably Mikko Rantanen. The Moose is something else. So
you're more of a player's guy and less of a team kind of guy.
Abs are my favorite team too. But yeah, I like watching the Oilers play a lot. Vancouver's a lot of fun this year, since I live right outside of Vancouver now. Yeah.
So you said your dad's from Jamaica. Your mom played hockey.
Yeah.
I noticed that you played for the Jamaican team.
Yeah.
A couple years ago. You want to talk about the experience?
It's awesome. I met some of the guys before in diversity not-for-profit for hockey called 43 Oak, and I met some of the guys there. And they were like, yeah, there's this Team Jamaica thing happening, and we're trying to get more people of just different descent involved in the game. And I didn't really know what to expect going into camp and stuff and playing with the team, but it was pretty awesome being around people who are, you know, look like me and stuff. But lots of the people, like, we have our citizenship in Jamaica, but we come from New York, Toronto, Montreal, Vancouver, different places in Florida. So it was really cool seeing that interconnectedness and just seeing that there are guys playing NCAA Division I, U Sports, WHL, OHL. There's been guys playing in the NHL, AHL, and Liga overseas, like all over. So seeing that there's guys that, you know, just like you, like, cause like in Saskatchewan, there's just not that many brothers. There's not that many, like East Indian people. There's not that many, there's not too much diversity. Just cause, you know, it's cold and they base themselves on agriculture, that kind of thing. So, you can feel isolated and alone a lot of the time. So then seeing other people who are like that, you make good connections. And I talk to a lot of the guys almost every day. I'm talking to the coach tonight. You just like learn that there is a network within the hockey world, and just seeing how small it is. And we won a championship out there, out in Florida the 1 year. I got the ring beside my bed. We were first team to win a even though it was lower division double IHF, we were still the first like predominantly colored team to win anything in that side of hockey. So just need to get a rink now in Jamaica, even if it's a roller one. Yeah.
So you've showed what you can do on the ice.
Yeah.
What's something that you love to do or a favorite thing to do while you're off the ice?
I like playing guitar a lot. I play guitar every day. I like playing the drums and just music. I love to do that. Love to like ski as well. But yeah.
Favorite musician? Fishing?
Yeah.
Favorite musician? Favorite kind of music?
I'm all over the place with music. Favorite musician? It's probably a band, Billy Talent from Canada. Grew up listening to them. They're a big hockey band. I don't know if they're big in the States.
I don't know, but I have to check them out now.
Yeah, they're Canadian band, so I don't know if too many Americans would know them. But yeah, favorite type of music, probably like, listen to a lot of country these days, but probably like rock and rap, like that Linkin Park kind of stuff. Grew up on that, so yeah.
Well, I think for getting to know you, thank for letting our fans get to know you. Welcome to Danbury again, and thank you for your time.
Right on, thank you very much.
I'm with number 6, Xavier Abdullah. X, how are you doing today?
I'm good, how are you?
Pretty good. All right, so you went to Wilkes University. How do you think that prepared you for the Fed?
I think Wilkes, as far as hockey, building great habits and just being a good hockey player, competing hard every day, and then outside of that, just being a good person. And I think that's something that that program prides itself on is growing men and as far as away from the rink and not just on the ice.
So away from the rink, you were there for 4 years. You earned a degree. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, I was there. I transferred from Stevenson University. I had my undergrad in marketing and then my MBA. So I was super thankful to have the opportunity to play hockey and get my degree there. So
as Herm likes to say, you have the most famous assist. Yeah. What was going through your mind during that game?
I think we were super confident the whole time. I think getting those two wins Friday, Saturday was huge for us. And then the whole game just trusting Gonzo, trusting my teammates. And in the last play, it's one of those moments you kind of black out and just play the game and let things come to you.
So speaking of Gonzo, he's finally returned. How do you feel being back with your D partner?
I love playing with Gonzo. We work super well together. It's super easy. Sometimes don't even have to talk, just kind of read off each other. So it makes both our lives easier.
So how are you preparing for the playoffs coming up?
Preparing for the playoffs, I think just doing all the right things away from the rink, eating right, getting the right amount of rest, keeping things loose too, not just focusing on hockey. So, still hanging out with my friends outside the rink and, doing things I love.
So my next question is actually, who is your favorite person or people to hang with outside of the rink?
Feels like a bit of a loaded question. I'll slot Yao in there as my roommate. I'll slot you in there. I'll put Gonzo, Ratty, Z, some of the guys that have been here around last year. I like MC and Stoge a lot. Those guys are good guys. But honestly, whoever I'm with, I have a good time. So I can't really pick one, anyone yet.
Yeah. And one last question. You're known to have good style.
Yeah.
Where is your favorite place to shop?
Got to be thrift store.
Yeah. Yes. You found any good ones in Danbury yet?
No. Honestly, the best ones in Wilkes-Barre that I find. Or Brooklyn. Yeah.
Have to go back there.
Yes,
all
ma'am.
Right. Thank you.
Yep.
welcome you back inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena in downtown Binghamton, New York. After 20 minutes of play, the Hattricks trail by three. The Black Bears scoring two goals within the first 2 minutes and 30 seconds of the period, adding another one at 17:48. Oliveri, Stefan, and Tosto, the goal scorers in that order for the Black Bears in the opening period of the second meeting of the weekend between the teams, and game number 17 out of 18 between the sides this season. So the Hattricks with some work to do, and who will they rely on? Taylor Joseph made 20 saves in the first period, allowed three goals. Nolan Egbert, a perfect 10 for 10, and a hat-trick start with Berry, Woolley, and Ratcliffe, LaBelle, and Bedard on defense. Teams flip sides, hat-tricks moving right to left in period two. And we are off and running. JT Walters in his own zone, back from a one-game suspension, did not play yesterday. Dan Weber gave it away at the Hattricks blue line. Josh LaBelle gallops around the net. His outlet pass was blocked initially, but Berry storms up the left side, one-on-one with Walters. Chips and chases. The Hattricks college rookie lost it to Weber. One hands for Clark. Bouncing puck, Woolley keeps. Too hot for Ratcliffe to handle. Walters swings it around. LaBelle keeps left point. Wrist shot. Whistles wide. Out the other side, Bedard. Down low for Ratcliffe in his skates, fighting with Fletcher for it. Rather, that's Weber, 61. And the outlet off the stick of Somero and all the way into the hat-trick zone. 1 minute erased, second period, 3-0 Binghamton. Kittrick tips it in. Johnson going after Stone, finishes his check. Bond, cross ice. Behind Kirkby, gloves it down, throws it forward. Oliveri, right corner looking. Shot off the side of the net. That was Thompson joining the play late. Here is Thompson shooting and a save by Joseph. A bit of an awkward play as the puck found the stick of Thompson. And Joseph denied him. Thompson tried to go five hole. And after a shaky start for Taylor, he has settled in. And now the Hattricks offense needs to produce to get them back in the game. Thompson dangles out of trouble to Fitzgerald at the left point. Wrist shot floats on goal. Joseph bobbled it with the glove. And it's chipped up the boards. Robertson can't clear. Fitzgerald keeps. He shoveled it in. Hattricks take possession, and Robertson through center ice. Cunningham offsides. And the whistle sets up a faceoff.
If one of the Black Bears players has a hat-trick in tonight's game, everyone in attendance will receive $5 off their bill.
Hattrick still 5 points behind Motor City for the number two spot in the Empire Division. Danbury with a game in hand. And the Hattricks losing in regulation yesterday, did not pick up any points, trailing by three here in the second period. Motor City does not play until next weekend, Friday, Saturday, home and home with the other Michigan team, Port Huron. And by April 13th, we should know where game one of the first round will be. Bouncing puck swatted by Woolley off the backside of Berry. Hattricks with numbers. Ratcliffe inside for Berry. Knocked down Fitzgerald. Ratcliffe has it back. Throws it to the middle. Spits out to Bedard, right point. For LaBelle. Wrist shot. Locked in front off of the leg of Woolley. And Bedard soccered it down. Woolley touches it. And the play offside.
Roman Acres Veterinary Hospital is proud to announce they are now offering urgent care share visits from 8
hat tricks had their six-game winning streak snapped last night by these same Black Bears, but the hat tricks have won 13 of the past 17 games. And a rare outlier of a first period for the hat tricks here in Binghamton. Allowed three goals and just got dominated. Didn't have much offensively, defensively. Surrendered countless opportunities on Joseph. We mentioned 23 shots in the first period for Binghamton. And just a stinker of a first 20 minutes for the hat tricks. We mentioned the good news, they have 40 minutes to turn the tides. They have the puck in the O-zone. Shot deflected off of a Black Bear and stopped by Egbert. Cunningham applies pressure in the corner. He gets dumped to the ice. Stretch pass for Clark off of his stick. Joseph out. One hands it further into the corner. Abdella connects with Cunningham at center. Cross ice Johnson. Wrist shot save. Egbert with the glove. And no rebound. Mentioned Yao Falanga, Zinchenko, Brown, and Tetro are the significant scratches for the hat tricks. Stoichevsky still on the IR, as is Murray. Tie up off the faceoff. Weber and Cunningham. It's Walters. Sent it for Clark. Zigzags into the zone around Robertson. Clark low left. Wheels around the net, pestered by Robertson at the right point. Walters tiptoes the line. Puck is kicked to Somero. Looking, shoots. Blocker saved by Joseph. It's controlled by Pamelin, and Robertson takes a penalty. He hit Clark up high. Binghamton, right back to the power play.
The Black Bears are now entering the Hinny Hard Seltzer power play.
Mentioned the hat tricks were a perfect 6-for-6 last night. They killed off the only opportunity for Binghamton in the first frame. So Robertson, in his season debut, clipped Clark up high, just off to the left of Joseph. It's either a high stick, an interference, whatever it is, it sets Binghamton up.
Denver penalties number 28.
On the power play.
Robertson, 2 minutes for high sticking. Time of the penalty, 4:24.
Kittrick pounds it as far as center. Oliveri sends it back for Bond. Ruiz tried to shovel it back for LaBelle into the zone. It's Logar and offsides. Choppy start to period number two. All three of the Binghamton goals coming in the first. Three different goal scorers, Oliveri, Stefan, and Tosto. The draw at the near dot, just outside the hat-trick zone. Back for Abdella, and he wails it down the ice. 5 minutes erased, second period. Hall of Fame night and Binghamton Whalers night here at Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. That's why there was about a 15 to 20 minute delay of the puck drop. We appreciate your patience and sticking with us. Bond swoops around the net. 1:05 on the power play. Oliveri, patient. Low left, centering pass. Kirkby scores! Tic-tac-toe. Kirkby roofs it, a power play goal for the Black Bears, and the lead extended to 4. So Kirkby with his team high 37th goal of the season. It is 4-0 Black Bears. And things are starting to get out of hand here in Binghamton. Hat-tricks need to find some offense, and they have to do it quickly. There's a power play strike for Kirkby, his eighth power play goal of the year. And he paces the group with now 76 points and 37 goals. Fitzgerald shoveled ahead, lost possession. There's Harwell up the right wing. DiNicola's in front. The pass for him, blocked by Fitzgerald. And Yates the other way. Yates into the zone, a whistle. There were some extracurriculars behind the play. I believe that it was offside, which explains the whistle. All Black Bears, early second period, and the Hat-Tricks are in a four-goal hole. We'll step aside right here on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network.
Stony Hill Dental Care has served as the leader and preferred provider of dental care in Bethel, Connecticut. Go see Dr. K. He'll make you look like $1 million and feel like it too. The official team dentist of the Danbury Hat-Tricks.
Vision Designs is the official merchandiser of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Vision Designs is a full-service screen printing, embroidery, signage, and promotional company locally owned and operated in Brookfield. Vision Designs is the hometown company with the national power. Check them out at visiondesignct.com.
Decker Tool Rental is the official full-service equipment rental shop of the Danbury Hat-Tricks, providing a complete line of quality equipment to all types of contractors, tradesmen, and do-it-yourselfers. Visit them today at 84 Federal Road in Danbury or on the web at deckertoolrental.com.
Kafala Coffee. Real coffee, good coffee, no, great coffee. Plus hot chocolate right on the concourse level at the Danbury Ice Arena. Kafala Coffee. Stay warm this winter.
Back in downtown Binghamton, Black Bears running away with things. It is 4-0 Binghamton. We've played just over 6 minutes in the middle frame. Hat-Tricks have been stumped offensively and have allowed 28 shots. Joseph has made 24 saves. And Binghamton extending the lead to 4. Earlier in this period at 5:28, Kirkby on the power play from Thompson and Oliveri, and the top power play in the league, striking once again. Hat-Tricks were 7-for-7 this weekend on the kill against Binghamton. Turnover, McKittrick shoots, was deflected over the net. Ruiz prying for it. Kirkby comes out of the pile, slips it as far as center. Henning charges back in, dangles around, and sprints after the puck. Johnson tried to turn and shoot, got shoved from behind. Hamilton fires, steered away. A whistle. Hamilton's helmet popped off of his head. And a penalty. Kirkby to the box. And a window for the Hat-Tricks to build some momentum and get back into this game. I did not see the penalty initially. Puck was in the corner. We'll relay the information to you. But the Hat-Tricks to the man advantage. They have gone back-to-back games without a power play goal. They're 0 for their last 10. And went 0 for 4 yesterday in the 2-1 loss to Binghamton. Steffen harassing LaBelle. And LaBelle tripped him up. So the power play lasts just 18 seconds. And now we even things up 4-on-4. LaBelle to the box for tripping at 7:28. Nothing going the Hat-Tricks' way thus far in Binghamton. So 4-on-4 hockey. Barry is out there with Ratcliffe, Gonzalez, and Hamilton.
Time of the penalty, 7:29. That's LaBelle, 2 minutes for tripping.
Hamilton leads Barry in stride, shoots, engulfed by Egbert, and he holds on. So an offensive zone faceoff upcoming for Danbury.
The winner of the Binghamton Hockey Rooster Hubs 50-50 raffle is ticket number 874254. Congratulations, you just won 1,000.
Patrick's with just two games remaining after tonight. As for Binghamton, they play three more times. They play tomorrow in Watertown. And they travel to Danbury on Friday and close out the season at home against Elmira. Here's Ratcliffe ripping one wide. And it springs all the way back into the hat-trick zone. Harwell and Ratcliffe up front. Harwell into the offensive zone, takes it wide, cuts in, lost possession with Bond on his back. The net was nudged off as Weber and Ratcliffe were engaged. Put the cage back on the pegs. Both teams make changes. More partial ones at that. Harwell stays on for the hat tricks, joined by Cunningham, Majard, and Abdella. 4-on-4, a lot more ice and a lot more room to work with. Hat tricks need a goal desperately just to give themselves a chance. Clark turbos up the left side. Abdella stride for stride with it. Clark cross slot, Bond fires, kick save by Joseph. Abdella reverses course. Cunningham chugs the legs. Yates all over him. Harwell slips it ahead. Yates and Cunningham tied up. They crash below the goal line. Harwell drops for Cunningham, has Bedard wide open in front, but never had possession. Still tied up in the skates. Now squirts for Yates. He's got plenty of room in front. Yates. Hands off. Clark. Waiting. Spins on Bedard. Centers. Knocked away. And there's Bedard. Banged off the boards. Looking for Woolley. Picked off. Binghamton to the power play for 15 seconds. Fitzgerald carries over the line. Leaves it for Yates. Clark for Anderson. Shoots wide off the back glass. Power play is over. 5-on-5. Black Bears in the zone. Yates inside for Clark. Steered away by Joseph. Clark was wide open. But Joseph got the stick there in time. A scrum. They wrestle for it. Pitchfork behind the net. And Ruiz. Gave it away to Fitzgerald. Hattrick's making changes. Somero up the left side. Binghamton with numbers. Dropped off. Fitzgerald shoots. Glove save. Joseph. And no rebound. And we are at another media timeout here in Binghamton. Hattrick's trailing by 4 on a Saturday night here in Binghamton. We've played a little more than 10 minutes in the second period. We'll step aside and come right back on the Hattrick's Digital Network.
Clancy Moving and Relocation. Moving is stressful, but it doesn't have to be. Call Clancy and let them do the heavy lifting for you. Resident and commercial services plus other services such as storage. Remember, Clancy is fancy.
Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury is the premier automobile partner in the Danbury area. Located on Newtown Road, the Bennett family has been putting the community behind the wheel for over 35 years. Dream big, drive a Maserati or Alfa Romeo. New and pre-owned vehicles available. Let Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury be your choice.
Dowler Garage in New Preston specializes in batteries, brakes, and general service. When you're stuck, you're in luck. Call Mike so you don't need a bike. Dowler Garage.
Peach Wave of Bethel. Located on Greenwood Avenue in Bethel, Peach Wave is your place to go for a quality treat. Frozen yogurt and toppings, it doesn't get much better. Catch a wave, a peach one.
Doug Latuca back with you inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena in Binghamton. All Black Bears thus far. 3 goals in the first, 1 here in the second. Shots are 30-15. And we're just over the midway mark of regulation. Fletcher and Berry on the faceoff. Binghamton wins it. It's 5-on-5 hockey. Patrick's killed off the remaining 17 seconds or so of the Black Bears power play right before the break. Fitzgerald to Fletcher, who ramps it in. Joseph is out of the net, rims it off the glass. Berry wanted to go on the transition, was turned aside at the blue line. Pamelain, D to D for Robertson. Shovels it high in the air. Fitzgerald knocks it down with the glove, pestered by Berry from behind. Fitzgerald gave it away to DiNicola. Berry, right up the middle. Berry shoots wide. Rebound off the off the end boards. And Berry's shot off the side of the net. Turnover at center. Flubbed back in by Robertson. And Fitzgerald will sauce it on the backhand to Logar. Flipped past Kirkby. Logar beats Ruiz to the puck, but the hat-trick's captain lifts the stick, takes it away. Cross-ice pass, kept in. Pamelain wins the battle. He leads McKittrick. He's in. McKittrick shoots. Saved by Egbert. It might have went wide. Thought Egbert got a piece. Johnson wrap around, try to force, and Weber intercepted. Weber up the right wing. Floats it in. Clear, knocked down. Kirkby for Thompson. Thompson looking, shoots. Grazes off the pad of Joseph. And LaBelle outlets McKittrick. 8 minutes to go, second period. Weber centers. Taken away by Johnson. Puck was chopped off of his stick. LaBelle keeps it moving. And Thompson carries over the blue line. Hat-tricks have not scored since the 16:30 mark of the first period last night. They lost 2-1 yesterday in regulation. They trail 4-0 here. Cunningham trying to dangle in tight quarters through the legs of Gonzalez. And Kirkby emerges. Hands off for Stone. Harwell took it away. Lead pass for Cunningham. Through him. Beats Bond to it. Dropped it off for Woolley. Stone stole it. And stop starts. Leads the breakout. Oliveri. He flings it in. Gonzalez on the backhand. Lost it to Oliveri. His shot blocked into the netting. And then after the whistle, Oliveri swinging his stick towards the face of Abdellah.
Do you have tech that got wrecked? Come on down to CPR.
And it does not appear that a penalty will result. Hat-tricks have certainly settled in to this game, but they trail 2-0, 2 minutes and 31 seconds in. It was 3-0 after the first period. And the one goal on the power play at 5:28 has pushed the lead to 4. Safe to say the Hat-tricks really need a goal. Ratcliffe in the slot shoots. Stopped by Egbert as he holds it up high. Honestly, they just showed the replay on that Oliveri shot that was deflected by Abdellah into the netting. It's LaBelle wrists one, snagged by Egbert. I mean, he fully swung his stick right in the face of Abdellah. And it connected. No call. And look, the Hat-tricks have flat out not played their best hockey, especially in period number one.
So no excuses at all. But power plays would certainly help the Hatricks just to try and get on the scoreboard at this point. The offense has been thwarted this entire weekend, with Ruiz getting the only goal. LaBelle kept out behind the net. Stefan backed off, got a change. Fletcher replaces him. It's Berry sneaking through. Turned back in by Binghamton. Joseph angles it for Henning, looks for an outlet. Finds Ratcliffe, kept in at the line by Fletcher. Spinning, taken down by Pamelian. Hand goes up, delayed penalty. Puck touched by Ruiz on a diving effort. And Binghamton back to the power play. They're 1-for-2, their most recent goal in this period on the power play from Kirkby. So they call a trip on Pamelian. Time of the penalty, 14:32. So a crucial kill for the Hatricks if they want a chance to mount a comeback. Hatricks are tied for fourth in shorthanded goals with 10.
Denver penalties.
Couple teams
55, Zachary Pamelian, 2 minutes for
have
tripping.
11. One with 12.
That's Pamelian, 2 minutes for tripping. At 14,
Kirkby skate the stick, drops off Logar. Back for Kirkby. Pressed down by Abdella. Couldn't get the shot off, and Gonzalez clears. Five minutes left, second period. 30 seconds have drained off the Binghamton power play. All the way around for Thompson. He's met by Abdella. They whack away at it. Down low, Kirkby. Shoved by Robertson. Left point, Bond. To Oliveri. Rears back. Waits. Finds Bond to Kirkby. Right circle. All the way across. Swatted down by Berry, who steals it from Oliveri. Couldn't clear. Ratcliffe does. Now to center. Logar slithers back in. 45 on the power play. Oliveri near the blue line. Crisscrosses with Bond. Now Bond. Pass down low. Shoveled wide by Kirkby on the doorstep. Black Bears keep it alive. Oliveri with 30 on the man advantage. Kirkby for Oliveri. Shoots, blocked by Harwell, who claps it all the way down. Both teams making changes. And the last 15 of the Binghamton power play. The Black Bears leading 4-0 on Hall of Fame night. And a night honoring the Binghamton Whalers. Walters. For Oliveri, power play is over. Weber for Oliveri. Spins, shoots, scores. Over the blocker of Joseph, he was screened, and it's 5-0 Binghamton. And this one is getting ugly, folks. Another goal for Binghamton right as the power play was expiring. It was just a turn and rip from Oliveri. Some traffic in front. Joseph never saw it. And it snuck in underneath the bar. So a five spot for the Black Bears. Harwell shoots. Egbert knocks it into the netting. And we are at the final media timeout of period number two. Black Bears having their way. Three goals in the first, two here in the second. We'll step aside of the Hatricks Digital Network.
Reverie Brewing Company is a featured beverage in the Danbury Ice Arena. Grab a Reverie and don't quit your daydream. When you drink Reverie, anything is possible.
Set Fitness is the official gym and training center of the Danbury Hat Tricks. Pump iron or tone up. Join Set Fitness and be the best you.
Mitchell, experience the difference. Mitchell has served the community since 1945. Heating oil, propane, and service for your home or business. Mitchell is ready to serve.
Oak Ridge Waste and Recycling has the roots in the community for all of your needs. Residential and commercial, Oak Ridge is the official sanitation partner of the Danbury Hat Tricks.
Hat City Physical Therapy is Danbury, Connecticut's leading provider of physical therapy and orthopedic specialists. Their highly skilled and caring team of licensed therapy providers are focused and committed to restoring your health and well-being so that you can return to the life you enjoy.
Doug Latuca back with you inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena, Binghamton, New York. Black Bears 5 and the Hat Tricks nothing. Hat Tricks haven't scored since 16:30 into the first period last night in their 2-1 loss to the Black Bears. And now in a 5-goal hole, looking for any positivity in the final 3 minutes and 10 seconds of the second. Hat Tricks win the draw. Abdellah is handing off for Gonzalez. Stefan swipes it ahead. Gonzalez goes D to D. Abdellah gains the red line. Flung in by Woolley. Walters could not clear. Gonzalez shoots, blocked. Weber took down Harwell, and a penalty. So they get Weber for a trip. So the Hat Tricks can build, at least get on the board here with a power play strike. Mentioned the recent struggles for Danbury on the man advantage. They haven't scored in the last two games. They're 0 for their last 11 on the power play. Ninth in the FPHL, just under 19%. And against Binghamton, they have 9 goals on 85 tries. It's about 10% this season.
Binghamton penalty number 61, Dan Weaver, 2 minutes for tripping. Time of the penalty, 7.
LaBelle for McKittrick. Return, LaBelle. Wrist shot, tipped wide. Cunningham pounces on it. McKittrick bangs off the boards. Fitzgerald steals it away. LaBelle kept it in, bouncing puck at the blue line. Ruiz down low, Cunningham to the goal, goes around in front, and Kirkby lifts it out. Binghamton on the kill is third in the league, 82.5% coming into tonight. Ruiz up the right wing, around the goal, angles for LaBelle. Across McKittrick, back LaBelle. Slap shot, tipped wide. Harwell camped out in front. Cunningham touches for McKittrick. They switch sides. Ruiz shoots, stopped by Egbert, and he holds on to the rebound with Harwell bearing down. Second unit out for Danbury. Fresh 4 killers for the Black Bears. The organ here at Visions Veterans Memorial Arena, special for tonight's game, with the Black Bears wearing the Binghamton Whalers jerseys. Always love hearing the organ, especially at a hockey game. Shorthanded shot off the chest of Joseph. And the Hat Tricks reorganize with 40 ticks on the power play. It's Berry who has 1 power play goal through his first 9 games as a Hat Trick. Willie pass in front, they score. It's Johnson, taps it home. Power play goal, and the Hat Tricks are on the board. So everyone's least favorite player here in Binghamton, Colby Johnson, grabs his 2nd professional goal, his 5th point as a Hat Trick. Skated past the Binghamton bench. Some jawing from the Binghamton faithful. Nice passing play by the Hat Tricks Woolley to the low right side near Egbert. And one of the easier goals for Johnson. All he had to do was touch it into the open net. So the deficit is down to 4. And the hat tricks connect on the power play. Walters dangerously emerges in front of the net, gave it away. Cunningham to himself, shoots, stopped by Egbert, and he drew a penalty. Puck in the skates of Ruiz. It's touched up by Binghamton, and the hat trick's right back to the man advantage. So Danbury with a little bit of life. They get a goal on the power play from Johnson. Woolley and Berry with the assist, and now the hat trick's right back to the power play. So Berry now with points in 8 of his last 9 games, 5 assists, 11 points during that span. As for Woolley, he's got 9 points in his last 8. 8 out of the 9 points are assists. Puck is flung into the hat trick's bench. And for some reason, the Binghamton fans applauding. Hope everyone's all right on the bench down there. 5-1 game. Binghamton scored 3 in the first, 2 in the second. 5 unanswered goals. Hat tricks with the most recent tally on the power play, and they're right back on the man advantage. 1:55 left on the Fletcher trip. McKittrick slips it for LaBelle. Slap shot. Stop. Rebound is covered by Egbert.
Number 11, William Berry. Time of the goal, 18:44. That's Colby Johnson from Woolley and Berry at 18:44 on the power play.
The penalty on Fletcher was interference at 19:02 of the period. Hey, well, if the hat tricks can cut this to a 3-goal game heading into the third, that at least that sets them up for a realistic comeback opportunity. They jostle for it behind the net, 30 seconds to go in the period. 1:30 remaining on the power play. Harwell kept it, there's Ruiz. Fires, stopped by Egbert off the stick. LaBelle floats it wide with 15. McKittrick walks the wall, up high Ruiz. Switches spots with LaBelle. LaBelle down low through Cunningham. The last 7 seconds in the period. Harwell to the right point. Here's LaBelle with 3. Shoot, save, rebound, score! No! Oh, it was stopped! It was stopped! I thought Ruiz slid it in! What a play by Thompson in the crease, kept it out! What a save! With 1 second to go, the LaBelle shot was stopped, and Ruiz wrapped it towards the goal, and Thompson swept it off the line. Unbelievable. Wow. I apologize. I mean, Ruiz had a wide open net, and Thompson behind Egbert got his stick on it. Harwell had his hands up in the air celebrating a goal. And Thompson, the hero, keeps it a 4-goal game. Unbelievable. The hat trick starting to play some better hockey in the back end of that second period. They have 1:03 remaining on the Fletcher power play.
For the hat tricks in the second period, 14, a total of 24. And for the Whalers, 10.
So the shot's 33-24 after 40 minutes of play in favor of Binghamton. So, some late period excitement from the hat tricks after Binghamton rattled off 5 unanswered goals. Through the first 36-37 minutes of play. Patrick's getting on the board at 18:44. Johnson from Woolley and Berry on the power play. And the Hatricks can cut the Black Bears lead to 3 on the power play once the final frame of regulation begins. Chuck-a-puck time here in Binghamton.
By the way, I want to say a very happy birthday to my assistant here, Zoe. Zoe is 13 years old today.
Now, the shots after the first period were 23-10. Black Bears. Hat tricks did outshoot Binghamton 11-10 in that second period. But the Black Bears outscore the hat tricks in the second with two goals compared to Danbury's one. And that is where we stand in the 17th meeting of the season between the hat tricks and Black Bears. The final road game for Danbury this season. They return home tomorrow and next Friday against Binghamton to finish off the regular campaign. Danbury is jostling with Motor City for second place in the Empire Division. Pucks are raining down here in Binghamton, and we will step aside here on the Hat Tricks Digital Network. Second intermission here in Binghamton, and it's a four-goal Black Bears lead. We'll take a break. Come right back. You're watching Danbury Hat Tricks Hockey on the Hat Tricks Digital Network.
Back.
I'm Jared. We're at the Rivery Brewery right now, helping them pack up the cans.
Yep, trying this beautiful specialty New England IPA you can get.
Hey, Zach, throw me a beer.
You got it, buddy.
Oh. I gotta catch those. I gotta work on my hands.
This guy.
welcome you back to Visions Veterans Memorial Arena in downtown Binghamton, New York. Doug Letuka with you. Thanks so much for joining us on a Saturday night at the Hattricks with a lot of work to do. At one time, trailed 5-0 in that second period. 16:38 of the second. Black Bears extended the lead to 5-0. Hattricks with a goal on the power play from Johnson at 18:44. Has Danbury alive and with somewhat of a pulse heading into the third period. Thought Ruiz had tucked in a goal with 1 second to go in that period, but Thompson swept it off of the goal line. It was past Egbert, and Thompson on the backhand whacked it out to preserve the four-goal lead. Hattrick still on the power play for 1:03, carries over from the Fletcher interference call. The Hattricks in the orange jerseys move left to right in period three. Top unit on, LaBelle, McKittrick, Cunningham, Ruiz, and Harwell. Gained the zone, flipped inside for Harwell, turned aside. LaBelle to McKittrick, shoots, his stick exploded, Kirkby out the other way. 2-on-1, Bond to his right. Kirkby waiting, shoots and scores! Joseph was fooled, shot never left the ice, and 24 ticks into the third. Kirkby's got a shorty, his second of the night, and it's 6-1. Not the return Taylor Joseph was hoping for. Finished up last season with Binghamton, was the starting goaltender in the playoffs in all five games. And the lead is back to 5 for the Black Bears. 30 seconds into the third period. 30 seconds remaining on the Hattricks power play. Woolley over the line, zigzags around Stone. Bond comes over and sails it down the ice. So Joseph entered tonight 3-0 as a hat trick. His first three starts. Tonight he's allowed 6 goals on 34 shots. Pamelian drops for Ratcliffe, fakes the shot. No unload save, and Egbert's got the rebound underneath.
Fans, with Johnson tonight,
right in front.
Decision. First, think about the dangers. Then think about the consequences. Stop and think before you
1:10 elapsed in the third. And the Black Bears regain that 5-goal advantage. Kirkby with his second goal of the night. Cunningham turns and shoots. It's blocked. Kirkby with 38 goals now. Tops the Black Bears. Harwell in the corner. Double teamed. Fletcher presses him up against the boards. Kicked free. Cunningham shoots. Blocked out of the zone. Cunningham sends it in. Rather, that was Gonzalez who sent it in. Cunningham pressuring Weber. And he swept it back into the Binghamton zone. Clark dancing at the blue line. Throws it ahead. Joseph out of the net. Touched for Berry. Outlet for McKittrick. Kisses it off the glass. And Berry in pursuit. All over Fitzgerald. Tosto. Hands off for Anderson to his D partner. Fitzgerald. A hit from Ruiz at center ice. Santosto tumbling to the ice. Woolley tripped up, tried to center. He was tangled with Anderson as they exchange shoves.
behind the play. Bedard off the end boards for LaBelle. Up for Woolley. Ratcliffe, left wing, hit by Anderson. Near boards, Woolley overskated. Kirkby outlets Anderson. Steps over the blue line inside. Kirkby shuts. Stop at the right pad by Joseph. Would have been the hat trick for the Binghamton captain. Stone cross ice for Oliveri. He'll shovel it in. Matrix reset in the defensive zone. Della lunges for it. Gets through the traffic. Puts one on. Stopped by Egbert. Egbert is 26 for 27 tonight. Two on one for Binghamton. Oliveri up the right side. Waiting, shoots high all the way around. Bond kept at the point, pokes it for Oliveri, his shot. Toe save from Joseph. Cunningham around the hip check of Oliveri, turnover. Kirkby for the hat trick, shoots. Might have grazed off the glove of Joseph. Either way, it stays 6-1 Binghamton. Thompson drops off for Kirkby. Pressed on. Inside Thompson. Shot it wide. Kirkby holding on to it. Finds Weber at the left point. Weber through everyone. Pass for Oliveri. Deflected. Kept by Walters at the blue line. Cunningham outlet for McKittrick. Intercepted. And Fletcher chugs the legs right side. Play is offsides. As Thompson was late to exit the zone.
Winning raffle number is 252438. 252438. Congratulations. You can pick up your sign.
Three goals in the first. Two in the second. One here in the third for Binghamton. Hat tricks with a power play goal at the end of the second. Just not Danbury's night. And the hat-trick's back in action tomorrow at 3 o'clock inside the DIA. Hat-trick's ice the puck. Face off to the right of Joseph. Hat-trick's player still out there after the icing. Barry and Fletcher. Barry wins it. Swept towards the goal. Stuff in try. Stick save Joseph. Ratcliffe. Cross ice Gonzalez. Rubbed off. And Walters. Stationed behind the cage. We've played 5 minutes in the third period. 6-1 Binghamton. Somero angles for Clark, shoots, deflected off the glass, and yes, it did go into the netting. So a stoppage, media timeout here in Binghamton. Black Bears with a five-goal lead will step aside on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network.
O Plumbing offers a full range of commercial and residential services. Their team can assist you in all aspects of any plumbing-related needs you have. You have hope with O Plumbing.
Kellogg Hardwood Lumber, located in Bethel, has the hardwoods for any project. They are a kiln-dried hardwood lumber yard and manufacturing facility carrying the highest quality hardwoods available. Flooring, moldings, cabinets, furniture, or whatever you are building, they have the kiln-dried hardwoods you need.
Since 1881, Omaha Beef Company has been supplying the Danbury community with meat and beef. Located on Maple Avenue, they are now the featured product in the Danbury Ice Arena. When you say Omaha Beef Company, you mean top of the line.
Bold Move Logistics is a family-owned and operated delivery service provider exclusively for Amazon. As a team, they deliver packages the last mile to your doorstep. Check them out on the concourse level at the Danbury Arena and inquire about joining their team.
We welcome you back to Binghamton, New York. Hat-tricks and Black Bears. 17th meeting out of 18 this season. Binghamton in control. Shots are 37-27 Black Bears. and the draw at the left circle. Harwell and Yates. Harwell swipes it back for Bedard. Given away. Steffen through the crease. Right point shot deflected. Yates with a rebound. He had his stick lifted by Harwell. Pamelaean darts up the right side into the zone. Pamelaean to the net, shot it wide. Pounces on the rebound. Bouncing puck, Johnson one-hand effort. Anderson stole it away. Pamelaean in deep. Yates. Real estate in front. Dishes off for Anderson, spins off a check, flips it in. LaBelle starts the rush. Fires wide. Ruiz with Johnson and Berry along the near boards. Johnson hauled down. And the puck spits below the goal line. Anderson nearly turned it over. Fitzgerald pressured by Berry. Fitzgerald emerges from behind the net for Kirkby. Looking back for Fitzgerald, turned aside. But Anderson waits for Fitzgerald to touch up and then floats it in. Now in front of the Hattricks bench, Anderson and Johnson. And potentially penalties. Both penalty boxes are open. And only Johnson will go. Roughing on Johnson in front of the Hattricks bench. It's a 5-goal game, and Binghamton back to the man advantage. They have scored once on the power play thus far, make it twice. Bar down, Dakota Bond, 7-1 Binghamton. Bond with his 16th goal of the season. His 10th on the power play. Bond entered tonight in second on Binghamton in power play goals. He has now tied Thompson and Logar with 10. So this game all but over. Still 12:35 to go. The Hattricks will most likely focus on getting their game together with Elmira coming to town tomorrow. We will be on the air for that game at 3 o'clock. Pass for Cunningham behind him. Johnson was in the box for interference, and Binghamton made him pay. Bucks sprung off the back glass and into the catching mitt of Joseph. 39 Black Bear shots, 7 goals, 27 shots from the Hattricks, and 1 goal. Weber at the left point, slap shot deflected. Samaro on the second chance was knocked off the puck by Henning. Pass to the middle, too hard for Samaro to handle. 3-on-2 for Danbury. Berry for Ruiz, inside McKittrick. He's got it around the net. D to D, Henning, wrist shot, fought off by Egbert. Kept in by Abdella. He shoots, and it's snagged by Egbert with the catching mitt. Hat-tricks with Harwell, Woolley, and Ratcliffe on. LaBelle and Bedard man the back end. LaBelle whips it wide. Bedard pinching from the right point. Down low for Harwell. Drops off for I think it's Woolley. He's tied up with Walters. Now there it was Ratcliffe. Number three, and an icing on Binghamton. Apologies there. Ratcliffe in taking a tumble and has some longer hair as the season has gone on. His flow has come in, still getting acclimated to the new lettuce for Ratcliffe. Face off of the left circle. Binghamton wins it. Walters with the fishbowl. Floats it out to center. Stefan at the blue line. Play is legal. And LaBelle swats it off the near side boards. Under 11 to go, third period. 7-1 Binghamton. Black Bears have iced the puck. Want to take a look at some of the scores around the league. Now, the game that the Empire Division is most focused on is that Watertown-Elmira game. It is 2-2, start of the third period in Watertown. Elmira has yet to lead in the game. Watertown has had 2 one-goal advantages. Thornton and Mercurio with the goals for the Wolves. Yarwood and Gesso for the River Sharks. Each team with a power play goal, and Watertown with a shorthanded goal. The game opening goal at 12:53 of the first period. Approaching the midway mark of the third. 6-goal Binghamton lead. DiNicola storms up the left side, goes wide on Fitzgerald, stapled to the glass. And Yates to the neutral zone and in. McKittrick in stride, drops off Cunningham, hard pass through, kick save by Egbert. He didn't even know where the puck was. He was just out. He was just sprawled out and made the save on Ruiz, who also didn't really know where the puck was. He's in his skates and deflected on goal. Ruiz robbed at the end of the second period. Would have been a power play goal. Would have cut the Binghamton lead to 3. Berry around Anderson. Fitzgerald pushes it to the near side. Kept in. McKittrick. McKittrick's outnumbered in the offensive zone. McKittrick to Berry. Shot stopped. Pops in the air. Glove down by Fitzgerald, who touches it. And a holding call on the Black Bears. And Jesse Anderson leads to a hat-trick power play. When we come back, media timeout here in Binghamton. 7-1 Black Bears right here on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network.
Charter Oak Brewing Company is a Connecticut-based brewery featuring handcrafted and innovative beers such as pale ales, lagers, India pale ales, brown ales, sours, and several seasonal, more robust beers. Pick one up at the Rabbit Hole.
Danbury Pace, Chipman, Mizuko, and Emerson is your partner for the road ahead. They provide comprehensive legal guidance for individuals, families, and businesses. CME, let the pros handle your needs.
Domino's, the official pizza of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Thin crust, pepperoni, sausage, you name the topping, and they got it. Domino's, they deliver.
Partner with Fastenal to simplify and secure your supply chain needs. They handle a vast range of industrial products, and if you want it, they can get it. The core belief is in the people at Fastenal. They empower their teams to do great things for yours.
Grounds Donut House is the featured donut of the Danbury Ice Arena. Stop by the main stand and grab yourself one of today's featured donuts. As good as it gets. Donut, miss out.
8:57 left. Third period. Black Bears with a firm grip on this one. They lead 7-1. Patrick's only goal coming back in the second period at 18:44 on the power play. Anderson is in the box for holding. Patrick's to the power play. Top unit on the ice. McKittrick feathers it to the right point. LaBelle kept in, tosses it off the boards, and McKittrick chases after it at center. Ruiz across for Harwell. He had his pocket picked. Fletcher shoots. Missed the net. Binghamton already with a shorthanded goal. It was Kirkby's second of the game. Black Bears clear it. They had an assist on the Dakota Bond goal. Kirkby and Logar with the assists on Binghamton's seventh goal. Johnson, left corner, rims it around through Berry to the right point, Pamelaine. Berry touches it for Woolley. Inside, Berry, tangled up. Johnson to a vacant right point. Johnson! 45 seconds on the power play. Woolley shoots, save Egbert, big rebound, and cleared by Binghamton. Woolley behind the back for Berry, kicked to Ratcliffe, and back for Berry. Patrick's had their six-game winning streak snapped yesterday. Woolley zigzags into the zone with five on the power play. Abdella shoots. Missed the target. Logar into the offensive zone. Spinning on Henning. Dumps it in. Harwell all the way around. Pass Johnson. Logar chips. Clark chases. Harwell down to the ground. Cunningham in front of his own net. Forces it up the far boards. Clark pitchforks it ahead. Johnson is back at the D zone. And he'll scoop it all the way down. Icing waved off. Harwell got there first, beat Stone. And now Binghamton lofts it out of the zone. About 6 minutes to go, third period. And the Hatricks ice the puck. Doug Latuca with you on a Saturday night here in Binghamton. Six-goal Black Bears lead. We appreciate you for sticking by. Be sure to buy your tickets for tomorrow's matinee, 3 p.m. puck drop, Hatricks and River Sharks, Empire Division clash. If you cannot make it to the game, I'll have the broadcast for you right here on the Hatricks Digital Network. Ruiz scoops it in, waffled to the far corner by Egbert. LaBelle at the left point. Shot it wide. DiNicola overskated. Squirts out to center. And LaBelle to Robertson. Now, he did have a nameplate on the back of his jersey, but that has been removed as it was starting to peel off. You saw it flapping in the wind on his previous shift. Yates over the blue line, around LaBelle. Yates to the middle, slid off of his blade. Steffen across for Anderson. Handcuffed him. Steffen, wrister, blocked. Yates flips it below the goal line. And Berry pitches it into the Binghamton zone. Anderson, right up the middle. Pocket pick by Ratcliffe. Final 5 minutes of regulation, 7-1 Binghamton. Oliveri took it away. Forced ahead, Black Bears offsides. They must touch up. Harwell offsides. And the last timeout of the night here in Binghamton. Black Bears 7 and the Hattricks 1. Stay with us for the final 5 minutes here in Binghamton. Tixer is the official ticketing partner of the Danbury Hattricks and Danbury Ice Arena. Log on and get your seats today. Great service and easy to use.
Tri-State Legacy Group is an insurance group that focuses on putting your family needs first. Consult with them today and set your plan for the future. They care about people over products. It's that simple.
Twister's Ice Cream Cafe. Located in New Fairfield, Twister's features 32 different flavors of ice cream. This season, they are stationed in the Danbury Ice Arena. Stop by and visit their stand. Get sprinkled.
New Haven Nighthawk Brewing. Brewed right here in Connecticut and featured at the Rabbit Hole. New Haven Night Brewing Company is the beverage of choice at the Danbury Arena. Grab a cold one and party like you're in the Elm City.
Kiss cam time here at Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Fans enjoying it. They're also enjoying a 7-1 Binghamton lead on Hall of Fame night and Binghamton Whalers night. That explains the orange, blue, and white jerseys for Binghamton. They've dominated since the puck drop. 5 unanswered goals, 3 in the first, 2 in the second. Hattricks did get on the board late in period 2, but the Black Bears with 2 more goals here in the third period have run away with things. Gonzalez locates Pamelain, floated through center and touched Fitzgerald to Anderson. Pamelain pinching, steps into the zone, cuts inside, Fitzgerald lifted the stick. Pamelain around the net, shoved by Fitzgerald. Kirkby to Thompson, into the Hattrick zone, lollipopped in. Gonzalez tied up with Oliveri. Oliveri looking for Thompson, denied. DiNicola goes back to Abdella. Under 4 remaining, third period, 6-goal game. Willie to Harwell, shoots wide. The dart at the right point. Rister hits off of Harwell, who has the puck on the near boards. Twisting in front of Woolley, so Walters takes it for Binghamton. Kirkby behind the goal. Bouncing puck, Logar and LaBelle going after it. LaBelle to Harwell. Last 3 minutes of regulation. Ratcliffe to Bedard. Waits, fend, passes inside, and there goes Weber. Weber loves it to himself, centering try. He's run into the boards by Bedard. So the Hattricks with just 2 more regular season games after this, and they're both at home tomorrow and then Friday against Binghamton. And then the playoffs start for this Hattricks team, trying to go back-to-back for the first time in league history. Mentioned, you see the Whalers jerseys tonight for Binghamton, but the Danbury Whalers, the only team to appear on the championship 3 consecutive years. Hattricks have clinched the playoffs in all 3 eligible playoff years. COVID wiped one of those playoff seasons away and one full season for the Hattricks. 5th year of operation, 4th playing year, and 3rd opportunity for the Hattricks to make the playoffs. And they've got a date with Motor City coming up.
Patrick's team that was hoping for 6 points, trying to sweep the final four games of the regular season, will come out of Binghamton with no points out of a possible six and two games remaining, trailing the Rockers by 5 in the standing. So the Hattricks will need 2 regulation losses from Motor City and 2 wins in regulation to surpass Motor City. Now, yeah, there could be a position where Motor City, oh boy, Cunningham just ran over Egbert. And let's see what comes from that.
Fans, get out your ticket for the Broom Sports Foundation.
Officials come in and separate. Was saying that, yes, the Hattricks can still top Motor City, potentially, if the Rockers pick up 1 point out of a possible 6 next weekend. But then you'd have to do some mathematics and look at the tiebreakers. It's points, wins, win percentage, head-to-head, and goal differential in that order. So Cunningham ushered to the penalty box. Goaltender interference is the call.
1794, that's 1794 on the hockey basket. 1976, that's 1976.
So Binghamton heads back to the man advantage. They have scored once on the power play and once shorthanded in this game. Binghamton 2 for 5 thus far. Hattricks win the face-off, but Kirkby takes possession.
Number 17, Corey Cunningham. 2 minutes for goal.
Oliveri at the left point. Fires a slap shot, stopped by Joseph with the glove, pinballed off of his blocker and into the catching net. An off night for Taylor Joseph. Allowed 2 goals in the first 2 minutes and 31 seconds of action. Did settle at the end of that first and into the second period, but that Kirkby shorthanded goal, probably one that he wants back, never left the ice, and he got fooled on it. Oliveri slap shot wide. Bond,
1 minute remaining.
With a minute to go in regulation. Oliveri for Bond. Across, Kirkby shoots at a save. Kirkby with 2 goals tonight. Black Bears trying to set him up for the hat trick. Bond at the right point, across Oliveri, shoots, stick save, Joseph. Final 40 in the third. Oliveri kept it in. Wines fires wide. Logar with 25 in the game. Bond shoots. Trapped by Joseph.
Continuing our record numbers, the Tommy Mitchell Sox and Skate Guards, 2033. That's 2033. The Jeff Brown stick is 1989. That's 1989. We also have one for 1986. That's 1986. The Corey Schneider goalie stick, 1797.
Oliveri and Robertson having to be separated at center. Harwell and Kirkby as well. And Oliveri's left glove is off. Are they going to let him go? Robertson dropped him. They both dropped him. And they won't let him go. Goodbye, Oliveri and Robertson. So, what do we have? 4-on-4. Well, it's a 5-on-4, I apologize. Still 48 seconds on the Cunningham penalty. And the final 15 of the game. Yates with 5 seconds. And that'll do it. Black Bears win it 7-1. They took a 2-0 lead about 2.5 minutes in to the first period, and the hat trick's final road game of the regular season certainly does not go their way. Trip back to Danbury, and they're right back on the ice tomorrow, 3 o'clock puck drop against the River Sharks. So the hat tricks have lost back-to-back games after coming into Binghamton on a 6-game winning streak. Hat-tricks now fall to 29-19-5, 83 points. It's third in the Empire Division, still 5 behind Motor City. As for Binghamton, they improve to 36-10-7, 113 points leading the way in the Empire Division. Hat-tricks with game 55 tomorrow, game 56 on Friday against Binghamton at home. All right, that just about does it for us here on the Hat Tricks Digital Network. Want to thank everyone behind the scenes helping out. I'm Doug Matuka saying have a great rest of your night, Hat Tricks fans. Danbury back in action tomorrow against the River Sharks, starting a 2-game homestand to close off the regular season. All right, good night, everyone.